Hello and welcome back to the Casual Gamer. First, I apologize for my voice. Unfortunately, I've come down with a computer virus. But anyway, I finally have the Legion Go in my hands, and today we're going to make it a little bit better. How, you might ask? Well, of course, by installing Linux on it. For this, you need an external USB drive, a USB hub, and a keyboard. My distro of choice is Nobara, and I've updated the device with the V28 beta BIOS before installing it. We're going to the Nobara website and download the latest Steam Deck ISO. Then we're going to create a bootable USB using Belena Etcher. First, we have to boot into the Legion Go BIOS and deactivate Secure Boot. We'll do so by pressing and holding the volume down button, then press the power button. Deactivate Secure Boot. Save and exit the BIOS. Now connect the USB hub with your external drive and keyboard. Reboot into the BIOS. Select the boot menu and then the USB drive. I had to reuse parts from the ROG Ally installation videos because my capture device did not work with the Legion Go. So please don't mind the username when it says ROG Ally. The process is the same. Once in the installer, select your country and complete the language settings. Up next, select a target drive. Just make sure you're not accidentally installing Nobara to your USB drive. And then select Erase Disk and continue to the next step. In the final step, you will have to set your username, computer name, and password. When you're done with that, you can go ahead and install Nobara. Once installation has been completed, select Reboot and let the Ally restart. Alright, now that we're in Steam, we're going to exit to the desktop mode. From here, we're going to update Nobara. Once this is done, reboot the Legion Go. We're going to return to the desktop mode once more. Open console in the system menu. We're going to install Steam Patch. Before we're going to reboot, install Decky-Loader for your plugins. Once the installation has been completed, we can reboot the device, and that's all we needed to do. We can change the TTP through the quick settings. Our refresh rate is 144Hz. Just make sure to disable frame limit. There currently seems to be a bug when it's enabled or if we set the frame limit to a certain value. I'm very happy with the current state of Nobara on the Legion Go, and I would actually stay on it. I did find the Windows experience a bit wonky, and I think it needs a bit more time in the oven. A lot of the stuttering that I experienced in Windows is now either gone or has improved a lot. And I have to say, the games look stunning on the Go's large screen. And yes, Lords of the Fallen is still broken on Windows, as you can see here on the ROG Ally. Sleep mode is working perfectly fine on the Legion Go, but what about FPS mode? While I personally probably never use it, I actually tested it in Doom, and to my surprise, it is actually working. In my opinion, Linux just delivers a much better experience on the Legion Go. And that's it for today. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed today's video. Thanks and hello to all the new subscribers. I'll see you next time.